Gearless and Valveless. This is the first sales brochure of the Gearless Automobile Company from 1907. They produced an interesting line of cars, but this factory photograph shows the remarkable roadster with a long hood, which made it even more dynamic. That is because under the hood lie not only the engine, but the transmission for easy access. Founders I.L. Fairbanks and L.A. Burley seemed committed to producing a gearless automobile. This was perhaps as a competitive marketing mechanism, or maybe just to be different, or maybe because of their belief in the gearless concept. In addition, they produced a valveless and gearless four-cylinder car. Although the gearless story is much more germane to the company, it is noteworthy that they claim that the valveless motor was known as a two-stroke, three-port engine, receiving an impulse with every revolution. Therefore, it had fewer moving parts than were possible to construct with any other type of engine. Quote, "It has one-third of the moving parts to keep an adjustment with no valves to regrind." They made this interesting four-cylinder engine for only 1 year and then concentrated on the gearless transmission cars. Apparently, the gearless transmission was not a consistent success. For instance, in 1907, they used the cone, cup, and cage roller. They claimed that this presented more frictional face to the rear wheels. Unlike bevel gears, there was no grind. In fact, it rolled. It was simpler than a planetary transmission, stronger than spur gears, and lasted longer. And it was also noiseless. Nevertheless, by 1908, they evolved this transmission, which shows a direct clutch with two contact points. This view shows the cantilevers, which were shifting essentially as levers. It seems that by 1909, their production before bankruptcy, they shifted into the ordinary friction disc transmission as shown above. This basic mechanism was not quite as unique as were the earlier attempts, and obviously, despite extensive advertising and a well-built, high-quality, complex construction, the company went out of business. An attempt was made to revive the company, which was supported by William Bausch of the Bausch & Lomb Company and George Roth. Financed the 1909 model year, which included the Olympic version, with the conventional transmission. Bankruptcy ensued, and this passed into history.